So, people, so you know that GMAT has four sections: verbal, quant, IR, and AWA. Today we are going to discuss verbal part. So, in verbal part, 36 questions, and the time you will get will be 65 minutes. In 36 questions, the concept or the topic that will be tested: sentence correction, reading comprehension, and critical reasoning. Remember, in GMAT, only sentence correction, then reading comprehension, after that critical reasoning are not tested. The questions will be in batch. What does it mean? In 36 questions, if the question starts with sentence correction, what if it starts with sentence correction? Then there will be two to three questions from sentence correction. And after that, the question will be from reading comprehension, three or four questions. After that, the next question will depend on your performance. Let me repeat, people. Your test starts with sentence correction. And remember, it's not fixed. It's sentence correction, reading comprehension, or critical reasoning. But the trend is with the sentence correction. So there will be two to three questions of sentence correction. And after that, there will be another, either critical reasoning and reading comprehension. But that reading comprehension or critical reasoning's level will depend on your performance. Find an example. First, in India, the basic level of question is 600. Okay, 600 level. Now, what if you got all three or all two correct? Then RC question will be 600 plus level. What if you got two wrong from reading comprehension and one right, one correct? Then now your level will return to 600 level. So if next is CR, two questions, so the level of CR will be again 600. What if you got two CR incorrect? Then now it will be minus 600. So what I wanted to convey, that your each level's performance will help you to go up or down, and therefore GMAT is considered one of the toughest exam. Why? Because each question is important, and that decides you are moving ahead or moving down. Fine. Now, so that was the level. What if you got all three correct of RC? Then it will be 750 level plus. What if all CR got correct? Then it will be 700 plus level. That is the pattern. I believe everybody is okay, whatever I said. If you want me to repeat, let me know. Now.
Yes, sir, it's fine.
Okay. So now the revision, the pattern is what? From sentence correction. And if you are making note, you can. If I'm fast, you have to inform me. Sentence correction. There will be 12 to 14 questions from sentence correction. What is mean of sentence correction? One, short passage is given, and sometimes completely, I mean complete passage, sometimes some parts of the passage is underlined. We have to find out best option that justifies underlined part. And to justify, there will be five options. Now, so what are tested in sentence correction? Subject verb agreement. How would you get to know that this is the subject verb agreement? When there is, are, was, were, have, has. That is called singular and plural verb. Singular and plural verb. First concept of sentence correction will be subject verb agreement. Second, modifier. Modifier means what? The placement of phrases or placement of words. That is called modifier. How do you get to know that this is modifier question? When there is comma, when there is WH words, when there is verb plus ing. Modifier part. Alisha, modifier means a piece of information for noun. That is called modifier. Example, aap ek example le lete hain. A very cool girl. Alisha is really a Punjabi ladki. Not Punjabi mahila, right? Yes. So, see the first part. This is a very cool girl is extra information. So, this is just to elaborate Alisha. Alisha. No, it's Alisha. So here, this part is called modifier. Why it is modifier? Because it is adding extra information in Alisha. So this is your modifier part. And how would you get to know? Because of marker. And rest we will discuss in the session. Same with WH words also. Example, a very cool girl whose name is Alisha is really a typical or is a Punjabi girl. So look, this part, this underlined part is what? Extra information for a girl, right? So this is called modifier. Alisha, do you want me to repeat? Topic that will be tested is pronoun. You know that know many pronouns, but in GMAT sentence correction, only it family, they family are tested. It's they, their, them. Sometimes it can be he or she. Not all pronouns, but it and they family are important, and then he and she. Next topic that is tested in GMAT sentence correction, tenses. So tenses means what? The role of action at different time. Example, if I say I was speaking now, so the word now is indicator of present situation, therefore was speaking is incorrect, it should be am, and that is called tense error. So in passage you will get some markers. On the basis of that markers you have to decide which one is the correct one, and that is called tenses error and test of tense. Next topic will be parallelism. Parallelism means balance in the sentence. And how do you get to know that this is tense parallelism question? Whenever there is conjunctions or idioms, it's been parallelism. Idioms means either or, neither nor. They are idioms. What if the sentence is Alisha is either a good singer or or are dancing. What if, although I am unable to find the correct word to justify. So this is called incorrect parallelism. Why it is incorrect parallelism? Because after either it is a good singer. Therefore, after or there should be parallel information, and that is called, instead of singer, it should be dancer. So that is called parallelism error. By the way, it is only word. In GMAT sentence correction, there can be a word, there can be a phrase, there can be a sentence, there can be a clause, gerund, participle, infinitive, all we will discuss. But in short, the concept of parallelism means what? Before and after conjunctions, before and after idioms, the piece of information should be same. Next is comparison. Parallelism means balance. It means whenever we put extra piece of information, that is X and Y. Suppose you said that I'm from Punjab. What if you said I'm from Punjab? And then after you want to add more information. So what would you do? Add conjunction. Once you add conjunction, then you have to add similar information before and next and. So I'm from Punjab and either you are, I live in Bhatinda. I'm from Punjab and I live in Bhatinda. So I'm from Punjab, one clause, and I live in Bhatinda, another clause. That is called clause parallelism. What if you said, I'm a good reader, then conjunction as well as. I'm a good reader as well as. So as you add as well as, it's mean you need to add same piece of information. So I'm a good reader as well as a good writer. It is not mandatory that the word good and good should match. No, it should be noun to noun parallelism. So I'm a good reader as well as popular writer, famous writer, a well-known writer. So here, reader and writer is called parallelism. Fine. Okay. Welcome, Andrew. Next is comparison. So marker of comparison is than, like, as. You know well than, x than y, like x as, like x y, as x as y. That is called comparison. And after that, idioms. What is mean of idioms actually? Combination of preposition plus word, that is called idiom. Remember, different than, this is called incorrect idiom. It should be different from. And there is no fixed rule for idiom, so you have to go through few points. I believe everybody's is critical reasoning. So critical reasoning means what? Logic based on argument. And what is argument? Actually, premise plus conclusion is called argument. Detail will be discussed in the session, but in short, first we pick an evidence, and on the basis of we make up mind, that becomes conclusion. An example: voice of Alisha is really so cool, therefore she must be a singer. It's an argument. The first part is fact. Second, on the basis of fact, I have concluded. Together, it becomes an argument. because of argument, now I have to justify the same argument. And that justification is called assumption, strengthen, weaken. So we have to justify from different angle. So in critical reasoning, you will be tested. In critical reasoning, the test will be assumption, strengthen, weaken, flaw, evaluate, inference, paradox, boldface. So these will be tested in critical reasoning. That will be the critical reasoning question. Remember, the critical reasoning question will be from 8 to 10. Now, reading comprehension. Okay, Sagar. Assumption means justification of argument. Suppose I say that Alisha has soft voice, therefore she should be a singer. This is an argument. To justify, I need one piece of information. That is called assumption. So the justification is, the assumption is, people with soft voice is a singer. So that is called justification of argument. In case of a strengthen, we have to go with the conclusion. What is conclusion? She must be a good singer, right? So we need a piece of information that should justify she is a singer. So her voice is always in a good rhythm. What if the option is her voice is always in a good rhythm and tone? That's become strengthen. Why? Because it is equal to conclusion. In case of weaken, we raise question against conclusion. So what is conclusion? She must be a good singer. Now, speaking softly represents business etiquette, right? It means what? She's not a singer. See the difference. That is called weakening. Okay.
Sir, how many questions did you say?
From critical reasoning? 8 to 10.
And any examples related to boldface type of questions?
It is equal to assumption question, but the line will be bolder. Suppose argument is given and the premise is bolder. So in option, we have to justify that what was the first sentence. The first bolder line is what? Is it premise? It is conclusion? It is background information? It is counter information? So we do not need to add any logic. But we justify that what is the role of the sentence. Now, next is reading comprehension. So reading comprehension means what? The passage will be given. So in reading comprehension, there will be four passages. All right. And four passages, generally, two short and two long passages. Shorter passage means there will be around 250 words. In long passage, there will be around 350 words. In short passage, there will be three questions. In long passage, there will be four questions. The types of question that is tested in reading comprehension is overall information, inference. Remember, critical reasoning inference and this inference are different. Inference, specific, evidence, and then factual information. So that will be tested, okay? Four passages, 12 to 14 questions, generally three short, one long, sometimes all four shorts, sometimes two short, two long, depends on, you know, performance. But there are four major types or questions that are tested. It can be extended to eight also, 10 also, but majorly overall information, inference means intended meaning, specific evidence means role of paragraph, and factual information is given or not given. That four are tested. Fine? All right.